Okay, so let us start building. The game is a very simple game of organizing odd numbers. It's not a very complex game. Reason why I have chosen this game is I generally like building games to understand concepts. So if you look at any React tutorial, most of the tutorials they focus to app. Most of them are to-do apps or counters. So although the examples are good, I find these kind of examples are interested in building interesting. I would always suggest building some kind of a game. So here is a simple game, quiz like game where you whether a number is even or odd. So I'll be using CodePen here. A simple pen in pen.io. The link description below. So React.js, the game here will be built using React.js. React.js is a very popular library. In CodePen, if you have to use React, you should first go to the settings. Then you should use JavaScript. JavaScript, we have to choose. Can you choose a React here? Type React. There are two libraries which you need to include. One is React and another one is React DOM. So although most of the videos or tutorials that they'll be using create React app, it's a great way to start building React apps. But for a beginner, I would always suggest going in this fashion, just including the CDN links for React and React DOM. Once you have included the CDN links for React and React DOM libraries for all, let us write a simple root component. This is just one div where entire app will get rendered. Most of the code will be in the JavaScript part. So in React, there is this concept of virtual DOM. To render something DOM, because we have included those two JavaScript files, we automatically get this React DOM object as a function called render. The render function takes component which is rendered. That component I'll be giving it as app. Then you need to tell where to render this app. So a document dot get element. I'll choose the ID root because I have given the ID as root here. But we have to create a component. It is showing an error here because we have not created any component. Need to be rendered in. So let us create a simple functional component. React has two components. One is functional component, another one is a class component. So class components were the first ones to be introduced in React, and they were very popular just a few years back before hooks came into picture. So hooks, React hooks are the ones which actually help you. So everything that you can do with class component using just functional component. You can create just a function called app. This app itself is a component which is rendered into the root component. Say return some JSX. And just for that React has been included correctly. So because once we verify that React has been included correctly, we'll proceed further and we'll. So you can see the output here. It is hello world. It is printing hello world. what happened here is that this app component has been rendered in, you can easily do this with any other library, but to React you can control the states. Topic will, what we want here is I'll just want to print some welcome to game, and then we'll print a line with number gets displayed and you have to pick whether it is fraud. The main app component, in this app component I'll be rendering another component called the game component, odd game. In this even odd game component, just for the time being I'll just render a static string, take HTML something. For the time being I'll say I'll just render a, say 30. Can say ask a question to the user, something a do it in the app comp. I'll create two buttons, button another button. The button or then we'll close the div. Of course, if I just save, you won't see any change in the output because we have not rendered this particular component in our app component. So I'll just say time being. Odd, and then I'll display the show this odd. Now, if I refresh, you will be able to see string which is coming from the app component and 30 odd buttons which are coming from the not game. Here we have fixed this particular value as 30. It is not very interesting because we are trying to build a game where the value keeps changing. This value needs to be stored in a variable. Let us create a simple variable here. Set and then to render this value now you are seeing the value being rendered through a variable. The variable, the value is stored and then we are rendering the value inside JSX part. Okay, now that we have a value not game, we have two buttons and odd. When someone clicks on the even button, we should be able to tell whether this is odd button odd. So let us write here, it will tell us whether the given value is even or odd. The function returns true if you need to take a value or to equal to else false. Of course, you can put this function outside. You can wish you can put it outside. Do not call. Now what I'll do is, when the button is clicked, you want to add a event listener in React. You on click. On click is present in normal JavaScript or vanilla JavaScript, but the C here is click. On click equal to, here you can give the name of a function which will get called, or you can directly define a function. For example, suppose I say one click, click on the even button, error, okay, so to use the ternary operator in JavaScript, because the Python code which I have. Turn mod equal to true, you return true. Otherwise, just need, you don't even need the ternary operator. Okay. Now there are no errors. Click, you get this alert. Clicked. So what I'm doing here is I'm just assigning this function get called whenever the even button gets clicked. Of course, you can do the same thing with the odd button. The odd button gets clicked, you just call another function. Call another function. Here I'll just put an alert odd clicked. Now if I click the even button, I get an alert called even click. If I click the odd button, I get another alert called odd click. Simple. Fine. So now we don't want this to happen, right? We want the app to get to verify whether the number is even or odd. Here the value is stored in this variable, and whenever the even button gets clicked, I should call this particular function, pass the value, and if it returns true, I should say it is correct. The answer is correct. Otherwise, I should say wrong. Okay. So I'll just create another function called verify. This verify function will tell whether the actually handle all the cases where the user clicks the even button, checks whether the value is even. If it is even, it just displays an alert that you are correct. If the number is odd, the user clicks a even button, it tells you are wrong. So this verify function will get called whenever I click here. Okay, so instead of this, now I'll say just say verify. Give the name of the function get called whenever the user clicks the button. Here I'll just put work now. Okay. When I click on both the buttons, the same function is getting called, the same verify function is getting called, and I am getting this alert. Fine. So here, instead of clicked, what I should say is alert even pass the value, and if it is true, I should say of course need to how do we know whether the even button itself has been clicked, because in both the cases the same function is getting called. So same verify function is getting called even when you click the even button, the odd button also. So I should have, there should be some way in which I should be able to verify in this particular function whether the user has clicked the even button or the odd button. So in order to do that, instead of directly calling the verify function, can call it inside a lambda function, big fat arrow function. So now, instead of directly calling the verify function, passing true and false value to the verify function, here button is whenever the user presses any key, these buttons, this verify function will be called with true or false. So gives it passes a true value the even button, and button has been pressed and the value is even, so an alert that correct. Just split this into a variable, const message equal to even value. Even and one button has been, this is one case, value is even, the even button has been clicked, this is one case. Another case is the value is odd and the odd button has been clicked. What we can do is we can, one case even and even button has been, or not even, even odd button has been clicked, the value is odd and odd button has been. If any of these cases is true, any of these cases is, then a true value is stored in the correct variable. If now I can just pull alert here, alert correct, the answer is correct, then I say alert win. Otherwise, okay, so now there are no errors. I click the even button, says you win, because 30 is a number. If I click the odd, says you lose, 30 is not a odd button, odd value. Now that it is working, you may say this value is fixed. Yes, it is. How do I make sure that value changing? Be able to somehow generate a random value every time on the app. Every time the app gets rendered, a new value should be so that you can this make this as a random number. You can easily do it by writing another function here. You can get random int. So because I want a random integer right now, for the time being I'll just fix it as a random integer between, can obviously extend on if you want. So here there is something called math.random. Math.random is a function which returns a random number. You can this dot random math dot random. Every time you call this, just get a random number 0 and 1. It is a floating point number. We want a integer between a range. So if I just say I want numbers between 0 and 100, I can multiply this by 100. Now you get two values before the decimal. If you just convert this into floor, just convert this into floor like math dot floor. You can either use math dot floor or math dot round if you wish. Just give. I just copy paste this part and copy this part and put, and I'll say return. Now instead of directly, what I'll do is I will call this one. Get random. So every time the app gets rendered, it should get a random integer. Test this, get a new. Every time you refresh this app, you will always get a new integer. Obviously, it should work for this also. Then open odd. Refresh, I get a new integer. Now this is 69, this is a odd number, odd in, okay, one close because not a fine. Hopefully you enjoyed this simple not game. Obviously, it is a very simple game and we will be modifying this, making it much more complex, because here we have not taken for as a state as such, because it just gets updated, the app gets re-rendered. So we are not setting the state in between, app is getting rendered, we are not in between. We can do all those things making use of React hook, which I'll be showing in the next. For watching.